We're live. Fabricio Werdum lost to Alexander Volkov. Fourth round, apparently a knockout. I haven't watched the fight. I was afraid of this man. I was afraid of this. These young bucks are taking over, man. They're taking over. But yeah, man. Fabricio lost. No speculate on that. But okay. The word of the day is reach, ladies and gentlemen. What you are seeing in the combat sports world is a radical change in the type of athlete that is at the top of the food chain. You are seeing the type of athlete that is leaner, that is more athletically built. For example, Deontay Wilder, extremely lean for heavyweight, 6'7", but yeah. The word of the day is reach, ladies and gentlemen. And in boxing, the one who has reach has the power. Another example of a boxer with insane reach is Tyson Fury. Tyson Fury, out of the trio that is Deontay, Anthony, and him, he's the one that will probably never face a boxer with an even higher reach advantage than him. Because, well, who is a champion that's taller than him? He is probably the biggest threat to either one of those champions. Why? They've never really faced people either equal in height, except for Anthony, or of larger proportions to him in terms of height. Deontay. I think Deontay can adapt to it. I mean, it's 2 inches, plus that's not a lot of reach. You know, I think Anthony, on the other hand, will have trouble adapting to that, despite the fact that both of them, Anthony and Tyson, both beat Klitschko. Deontay, to me, seems like the more absolute fighter. But the math ultimately breaks down there. His record is as impressive, if not more impressive, than Tyson Fury's and Anthony Joshua. He's been knocking people out for a while now. He only has one decision to his name. I think it's the decision remains to burn. The first fight. The second fight, Deontay destroyed him. So clearly this, after the AJ and Deontay fight, Tyson should be next on the line. Let me know what you think, guys. Like, comment, subscribe.